My name is Heinrich Barth. I'm an historian and geographer. I was born in Hamburg on 16 February 1821. I studied in the University of Berlin, where I learned English, French, Spanish, Italian, Arabic, and several African languages. First, I traveled to the Mediterranean coastal areas and described these travels in my book called Walks Through the Coastal States of the Mediterranean. After, I made an expedition to Sudan, the Sahara, and Western Africa. When I returned to London, I wrote about these travels and published the book called Travels and Discoveries in North and Central Africa. Also, I made a collection of Central African languages. Then I visited the Turkish provinces and wrote other books about these places. At the end, I was granted a professorship of geography at Berlin University and appointed president of the Geographical Society. My main expedition was in the year 1850. The British government organized an expedition to open trade relations with the territories of Central Africa and west of Sudan. The leader of the expedition was the explorer James Richardson. In addition, the astronomer and geologist Adolf Overweg came with us. We left from the city of Tripoli at the beginning of 1850, and we crossed the Sahara Desert with great difficulty. Richardson and Overweg died, and I assumed command. I explored the area of south and southeast of Lake Chad and mapped the upper reaches of the Beni River. After, I traveled to the city of Timbuktu. I remained there for 6 months before returning to London in 1855. I had traveled 16,000 kilometers. I was interested in the history and culture of the African people rather than possibilities of commercial exploitation. I liked the knowledge and exploration of the territories, cultures, and languages of the world. I wasn't interested that the European countries occupied these territories to be their colonies. The territories and their resources belonged to the people that lived there. Europeans weren't superior to people living in Africa. I was against slavery. I didn't like that Europeans traded with slaves and that they took advantage of the Africans. I was against colonialism. I resolved upon undertaking, with a very limited supply of means, a journey to the far west in order to reach Timbuktu and to explore that part of the Niger which had remained unknown to the scientific world. In this enterprise, I succeeded to my utmost expectation, and not only made known the whole of the vast region, which even to the Arab merchants in general had remained more unknown than any other part of Africa, but I succeeded also in establishing friendly relations with all the most powerful chiefs. I have the satisfaction to feel that I have opened to the view of the scientific public of Europe a most extensive tract of the secluded African world.